I hate mashups. They make me nervous, you know?
Why do they make you nervous?
Because when people mash up, they take two songs that don't belong together, and then you find yourself really wanting it to work. Like you go, that sounds cool, but it doesn't sound cool. It always sounds off. But I think I found a mashup I like.
This one works.
This is Led Zeppelin and Sabbath together. Ozzy and... It's good. I think this one works. Whole Lot of Love and War Pigs mixed together.
All right.
All right, you ready?
Six 16 on the phone. Tom Campagnoni. Let me tell you something about Tom. He's probably the best mashup guy in the world. You know what a mashup is? You put a couple of songs together, you come up with one. Yeah, mashups are becoming very popular on the internet. Tom Campagnoni does them as well as anybody.
He likes his AC/DC. He likes his Metallica when it comes to...
Oh, did you do a lot of AC/DC?
There's a few AC/DCs in there. His name is Tom Campagnoni. He's an Aussie.
How did you know how to pronounce that, Will?
I actually went on to Google and said, how do I pronounce Campagnoni? And put it into Google, and an American voice told me,
Campagnoni.
And I was like, that can't be right. So I emailed Andrea Costanzo, our one Italian listener.
All right.
And said, dude, do I pronounce the G? And he went, no. No, you don't. And I was like, I knew it. I knew that bitch was lying to me. Campagnoni.
Tom Campagnola. Tom Campagnoni.
Tom Campagnoni, welcome to the Bob Rivers Show. How are you?
Hey, Bob. How you doing? Nice to be here. Hello, Seattle.
Hello. Good day, mate.
G'day.
Hey, Bob, thank you for that.
The way you said my last name is so impressive because all my school teachers who I had for, 10, 12 years, they still couldn't say it at the end of my time.
No kidding.
You've pretty much nailed it, so I'm really impressed.
Well, now that's an Italian name, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, that's right.
I grew up in an Italian neighborhood. In fact, I was like the only...
Ah, there you go.
All right, in at number four today, a nostalgic mashup by YouTuber Wax Audio.
Guys, what happens when you combine AC/DC's rocking ode to the elements, Thunderstruck, with the jaunty theme song from 1984's Ghostbusters?
Well, the answer is Thunderbusters.
Bye.
I think this is great, but you don't like it, Richie Matheway.
No, I don't.
What? This is fun.
Yeah, it's fun.
And it rocks.
Fun. It's fun.
Bustin' but... makes me feel good. Bustin' makes me feel good.
Song Ghostbusters that ripped off Huey Lewis's I Want a New Drug. That is more awesome than that.
What is he doing? Right now he's unemployed.
Why?
So, in Canada you have to make sure that as a broadcaster, even when on a show there's some Canadian content.
Buy and sell stuff.
So, we're going to do a little Bryan Adams.
Cars.
Yeah. And Metallica at the same time.
This is kind of one of my favorites of yours. It's really quite simple. I'm a huge fan of both those songs and artists, or certain parts of... I like both of those artists' early work, let's say.
Yeah.
And the humor value in this one, for me, is just so over the top, because the idea of combining these two artists is just so funny. And I think a lot of other people get that humor as well. I'm sure you had quite a smile on your face as you realized that it was going to work. And before I let you say anything about it, I just have to make comment about the artwork for this song, because you created artwork for every mashup you did, or certainly all the ones you released. And a lot of them were great in themselves, but it's so exquisite, and it's so the visual representation of the tune. And I just fucking love it. What have you got to say about this particular song?
When I put that up online, I used to write little blurbs to go with each mashup.
Right.
I wrote something like, let's go back into an alternate universe where a young James Hetfield didn't meet Lars Ulrich. Instead, he met Jim Vallance.
Jim Vallance is Bryan Adams, was Bryan Adams' long-term writing and publishing partner.
That's right. And so that was up online, and sure enough, that rang a bell in the Jim Vallance camp. A couple of days later, in my inbox, there's a very short email from one Jim Vallance, just says, well done. Cheers, Jim Vallance.
You forwarded that straight to me, and I was just, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
That's it. We're watching the video. 3, 2, 1, buckle up. Let's watch it.
I think I need a drink for this already.
Oh shit.
Judas. 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 Jud
don't keep it inside. Just say something.
Dude. like.
Don't keep it inside. It's wrong if you're keeping it inside. You should let it out.
Where to begin? we were already at 10. Just got cranked to 11. The meter is about, it's about to freaking explode. I feel like that moment in Back to the Future, you know, when Michael J. Fox, he plugs up that guitar and he's in Doc Brown's like house or basement and he goes, wow. That's what just happened to me.
And trust me, your grandkids will love this music.
Hit it. I can roll.
It exploded immediately on YouTube. It just went straight up, probably a million views within a couple of days.
Fuck.
Yeah. So.
Was that the best you'd had so far or the quickest?
Probably the quickest. I'd had other videos with over a million views, I think. But
yeah,
that was certainly the fastest anything has rocketed up the.
Rocketed up the charts.
Yeah. I mean, the cool thing was within I don't know how long, I got a little alert. Rob Halford had mentioned the mashup, or he was asked about the mashup in an interview.
Rob Halford, the singer of Judas Priest.
Rob Halford, the metal god, talked very approvingly about the mashup and how he'd seen it on YouTube. He watched it sort of backstage with one of his friends on the iPad, was really, you know, psyched about it, just loved that it had so many views.
You didn't get a direct response from Madonna, but Madonna did post a video of her playing some Led Zeppelin, right? As a response to one of your tunes.
Yeah, I mashed up Justify My Love, the Madonna track, with Whole Lotta Love.
That's right.
By Zeppelin. And again, you know, within a few days, Madonna posts an Instagram of herself playing Whole Lotta Love on guitar. Couple of days later, I looked at my Twitter and suddenly I'm being followed by Madonna's guitarist.
Right.
And I immediately send him a message. Hey, how's it going? Has Madonna seen my mashup? Is that why you're following me? And he said, yeah, absolutely. We watched it. She loved it and she wanted to learn how to play the riff. That was cool,
yeah.
But that was nowhere near as cool as what happened next, which is probably the coolest thing ever. Jimmy Page posted the video on his website. The splash page of his website was my video. Underneath it said, Happy Birthday, Madonna.
Wow.
I think this one works very, very well. I
you
think,
know he sat back after this and
went, I have done well.
It's the only time.
I have done well here.
I got a request to do this one video. It came out of the blue. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to do it because the guy said that it is pretty wicked. It's pretty awesome. I guess it's Bee Gees from like the 70s. Yeah, I know who the Bee Gees are. But he said that it's like AC/DC with it. I'm not sure. But I'm going to see what it's all about. He said it's going to knock me out of the park. And it's going to rock my world, I guess you want to say. But I guess we'll check it out. So let's get into it.
This is genius.
It's alright, it's okay. You may look the other way. We can try to understand that we got times of that of them.
So that's what you do? You just stomp on a camera and just show your butt and then stick the middle finger up? Like, what, bro? Bro, they be coming up with anything on TikTok, man. I swear. Yo, this trend is dumb, bro, for real. It's like, what's the point of this, man? This is crazy, man.
Not bad. Actually, that was pretty damn awesome.
That was intense. That was awesome. That genius.
We'll be right back.
It's classic. You know, like 7.5 million people have viewed that. It's just, you know, the perfect blend of two songs, and that's what a mashup is supposed to be.
You know, mashups to me always go wrong, but someone sent this to me on the internet. They took Stevie Wonder and Metallica, you know, and it works. I think this one, tell me if you think this one works. Coming at you, WMBC, got a little Stevie Wonder and Metallica, because why play the originals? We're going to mash them up. Why should we play you the way the artist wants it? We're going to fuck with it.
There is superstition. Writings on the wall.
See? That works.
There is superstition. Letters by the fall.
There you go. What do you think?
Let me listen for a while.
If you listen too long, you start to hate it.
Okay.
Trust me, I probably tuned out about here because I didn't care after a while. I think I realized, like, I was like, hey, this works. And I went, but who cares?
Nice.
The writing's on the wall.
Very superstitious. Let a bow fall.
Mashups are just a big waste of time.
Does it make it better? Does it make either song better? No.
No. Some imbecile in his basement knows better than Stevie Wonder what his song is.
Oh, and you believe in things
because I love music. It's in my head, I can't get it out. Yeah. You know, I don't know why. I hear it now.